would like to remember some statements that we need today. Okay, so let's be a separable mana space. Then definition of MPEG 2 banners. Okay, no. I don't remember because it's only the statement which is fundamental for us. Of M type 2. Then we discussed yesterday that given a centered Levy process, which is square integrable, and real valued, on filtered space omega F FT P. With variance, we know that it's linearly increasing dt. Then we know that as the state space is a separable Banach space of M type 2, then if we define the Itô integral first on the sample functions as a Lebesgue-Stieltjes integral, then we know, so in this case it's Lebesgue-Stieltjes integral, that due to the structure of the MTEC2 Banach space, so due to the structure of the Banach space, there exists a uniform constant k bigger than zero such that the norm of our process, okay, the norm of our process here, of the stochastic integral, in the space of square integrable martingale, we know that it is a square integrable martingale, and this is the norm to the square. Is less equal than this constant k of the norm of the integrand in L2. We indicated it, I think, like this, which is hence k, and the norm was d of integral 0 t of e of norm h a square in the s. So we know this constant to exist, such that this is true. And due to this fact, we know also that due to this inequality, we know that this operator here can be prolonged to be a continuous operator on the whole space of L2 integrable functions. So as a consequence, because obviously if you have a Cauchy sequence here you will have also a Cauchy sequence here due to the inequality. So as a consequence, E can be closed to a continuous operator. On the space of L2 adapted random stochastic processes. So the Itô integral is well defined for any random processes which has second finite moment. Okay, so I wanted to tell you this because so now you feel have not the feeling I'm doing something strange if I will speak about stochastic differential equation where the stochastic processes has value. Where this integrand here and the stochastic processes has value in an M-type 2 Banach space. Okay, so we want today to speak about Banach-valued stochastic differential equation. And you will see that once we have made the assumption that these integrals are well defined, everything is equal like what you know already for the Brownian motion, because we have seen that Levy processes, which are square integrable and real valued, have the same properties as the Brownian motion, the properties we usually need, which is simply that the variance is increasing linearly, that they are stationary and additive. These are the main properties that we finally need. So nothing is different from what you know, in fact. Okay, so we assume here again now to have Lt to be a square integrable centered real valued Levy process. And with respect to this, this will be the process defining the noise in our stochastic differential equation. So this is defined on some filtered space. And obviously, we will look for solution on the same filter space because we want to observe the solution on the same space as the noise. So we consider the stochastic differential equation of this kind, which is dxt equal to atxt in dt plus sigma txt in dlt, where we assume that A and sigma are progressively measurable. So let me say what this means. So here I didn't write omega because we don't use to do it, but A, the drift and noise coefficient A and sigma depend also on omega. And we want them to be progressively measurable. Which means they are measurable in all variables together, but they are also always adapted. So we say that, so let me say what is the space of progressively measurable functions on our filtered probability space. So in this case, we consider the functions which are defined on the product space of R plus times E times omega. And we want them to be measurable in any case with respect to the product spaces of the Borel function in B, in R plus and in E, which is our MTech2 Banach space, and on the sigma algebra at the final time t. And this function have values in E. So H is in this, I just shortly write here proc E for writing all this stuff here in a short way. So H is in the set of progressively measurable functions if it has the following properties. Well, first of all, it is defined in R plus times E times omega with values in E. And it is, sorry if I write now here, it is B R plus, it is measurable with respect to the product Borel's sigma algebras with FT also, but also it is H of T X is for each is FT adapted for each X fixed in E. And obviously this holds for any T. So in fact, for any T in R plus, the following holds: HT X is, if you fix X, adapted. Okay. So this is somehow the minimum of properties we need for H, because we want it to be measurable in the whole space, but also at any time t to be adapted to the filtration. So already we said, I think, what is a strong solution. Let me just recall it, because if you don't recall it, then you might have problems in following this lecture. And then we will give a sufficient condition to existence and uniqueness of a strong solution of this stochastic differential equation in any time interval 0t. Okay, so okay, just let me remember a process 16 on the same filtration. So on omega FT, which was the filtration of our Levy process. With values in E. Is a strong solution in the interval 0t. If P, almost surely, it holds for any t in 0t. So P, almost surely, it holds for any t. Xt is equal to x0 plus the integral of 0t of as xs in ds plus now the stochastic integral, which we know to be well defined, at least if sigma is in L2 of XS in DLS. Okay, now theorem. In infinite dimensional spaces, obviously we have the same problem as people in analysis. So it is not easy to prove existence and uniqueness under general condition. And you should then find the usual methods that you use in analysis. For example, to prove existence and uniqueness, you need some conditions on the coefficients, like, for example, Lipschitz condition and growth condition. And this Lipschitz and growth condition permit you to make a fixed point procedure on the correct Banach space. I mean, you know the problem from analysis that, yeah? So it's not different here. So given, and we will also put this Lipschitz condition here, and we'll do a fixed point procedure to prove existence and uniqueness of the SDE. So given any t bigger than zero, so let us assume E to be a Banach space of MTech 2. Or if you don't like it, you take a separable Hilbert space, which is always a Banach space of MTech 2. Because the inequality then holds with the isometry, yeah? It's a particular case. But it's only really a particular case of this. And suppose that the initial condition has second moment, which is finite. Well, this could be, what I say here could really be generalized a little bit. And what I'm doing here is to reduce to the case where we integrate with respect to the Levy process that of the case of the Poisson random measure of what we did in a book together with Stefan Tappe and Asma Mandreka. But you will see that for this case where I reduce to the Levy process instead of the Poisson random measure, well, it changed something because I'm taking MTech 2, but it's nothing different from what you know, because MTech 2 I needed only to define, to have this to be well defined. The rest is equal. And as I said, in that particular case that here is really L, you can imagine to be the Brownian motion, and what I present here is what you know, probably. Yeah. Anyway, as I took it from our book in preparation, I wanted to stress this here. Okay. So we assume now a growth condition. So the growth condition holds. Which is the following. We assume that there exists a constant m bigger than zero such that, if I write here, probably you cannot read, right? So let me clean the black points. Okay, I prefer to have it clean because to interrupt a proof is not so easy. It's better to interrupt before. Okay, so, yeah. Sorry? Yeah, thank you. Okay, I suppose there is a constant M such that the norm of the drift coefficients squared plus the norm of the noise coefficient squared is less equal to the constant M times the square of X plus 1 for all T, let me write this here, such that for all T in 0 T, this is true, and X in E, this holds P almost surely. And a Lipschitz condition holds. Which is the following. I suppose that the integral from 0 big T of the norm of S x minus A S in epsilon squared in the S plus the integral of the same thing for now the noise coefficient is less equal to the constant L times the norm of X minus epsilon squared for all T bigger than zero and for all X epsilon in E. Again, P almost surely. Okay, if we assume all that, then there exists a unique solution, a unique strong solution in the space ST2, which I will say what it is. There exists a unique solution of the stochastic differential equation, and it's unique if I consider all possibilities in the space STU. So X now in 0 T is in the following space. And this is true for any T bigger than 0. I mean, for any T bigger than 0, there exists a unique strong solution in this space. And this space is the Banach space of Cadillac adapted processes. Zeta, which are equipped with the expectation of the sup of the squared supernorm. So the norm is equal to the expectation of the soup in the time interval t 0 t of the square of zeta t. Obviously, the square root is the norm. So obviously now I am cheating a little bit because I write, it would be an obvious thing that this is a Banach space. This has to be proven, but I won't do it here. It's really too long. We did it in our book, but so I ask you to believe us. Yeah. Yeah. No, not, no, it is not depending on t. Ah, among big T, yeah. Sure, you are right, sorry. Yes, maybe I should write like this. Yeah, yeah, but it is important to stress it. We forgot it in our book, right? Thank you, we should do this, yeah. Okay. So the method is the usual one you know from analysis, I think, yeah? So in analysis, if you would have a stochastic differential equation, well, this term is not there, and the value is in a Banach space. A typical procedure to do is to do some fixed point procedure. And I will do exactly this, nothing new, yeah? But obviously here I have the noise term, but this noise term can be nicely controlled in the second moment by the second moment of the second moment in the L2 space due to the inequality we saw before, yeah, which was true obviously not only for the sample function but by closing it was true for all L2 adapted function. So this inequality doesn't not only give us the guarantee that this is well defined, but gives us also the control on this that we need for the fixed point procedure. So, sketch of the proof first, and then some detail of the proof, but not all. Okay, sketch of the proof. Define the operator S acting on zeta, so a process in ST2. So I take any process in this Banach space ST2, and I mean, if I want to do a fixed point procedure, obviously I want to do it in a Banach space. So, I mean, the point of the proof is to find the correct Banach space where you are able to do the fixed point procedure. So, such that this process, the process that you obtain after having applied the operator, the new process, has the following properties. At any time t, this is equal to x0 plus the integral of 0 t of a s zeta s in ds plus the integral in 0 t, sigma s zeta s in dls. So you see, this is nothing else than this right-hand side. Well, at first, I just put a process of my Banach space st2 where I want to make the fixed point procedure. And I will show that s has a unique fixed point. And if S in ST2 has a unique fixed point, then this means that zeta is equal to S zeta t. But this is only a short way to write exactly this.
Yeah?
So I have done. I have a too big handwriting, so I'm always cleaning this blackboard. But I can change that. I always try to write smaller, but I it doesn't work. If I write smaller, it becomes more disordered. Ah, maybe the statement should be there. Well, too late. Ah, really, I needed the statement for later. Well.
Okay.
So, in other words, one has to prove. It can be proved. So this is only a sketch. So later on, I show you only some parts of this proof. First of all, that this operator, I have to make sure that it is acting from ST2 to ST2 if I want to have a fixed point in this space. And once I have shown this, I show that if I apply the operator several times, then this is for up to some n bigger than n0, a contraction. On this ST2. And this is proven by showing that this is true. I will show you to you, or give you a sketch of the proof. And two, it's shown by the following. You can show the following inequality. That it might be strange for you if I write now the inequality. But when I have shown one, which is shorter, as a proof, you will also understand how I end up with the second inequality, because the principle is exactly the same, only the calculation are longer. So two is shown by showing the following inequality. So I call it inequality C because it's a contraction inequality. That E of the sup of the norm of Sn epsilon t, I mean, here I want to show that there are, if I take two possible processes, then this is a contraction. So I consider two possible processes in ST2. And then I show that the difference is contractive up to some n. Because this is smaller or equal to a constant, which to the n times t to the n divided by n factorial of the norm of the two processes in ST2. I mean, the distance in the norm of the two processes. And the distance, let me write it here, times times the norm in ST2, which is the sup on 0t, of the norm of epsilon t minus zeta t square. Okay, so how I end up with this, you will see it. Yeah. So this difference is smaller than up this constant times this. So in particular, if n goes to infinity, this goes to zero. And therefore, once shown this, we can deduce that S has a unique fixed point. Xt in ST2. And this unique fixed point, let me call it X, big X, and this unique fixed point X, if I write that it has to be X equal SX, but S equal XS, you can, now I erased what I wrote before, but if you look in your notes, this is nothing else than the stochastic differential equation I wrote. So, assuming that you believe me that 1 and 2 can be proven, we have done. So, 2, now I won't do it, but I want to show you that S is acting from ST2 to ST2, and I will do some inequality. The way I do the inequality is exactly the way I will obtain this inequality, but with more calculations, because in that case I have to apply S several times, so in some sense I have to apply the inequality several times. But it's the same thing, so I don't do it here. But I show you how it can be proven that one is true.
Yeah.
Or at least I give some idea. Yeah. Yeah. No. It's uniform. Yeah. I don't remember if it's depending also on M. I don't think so. On the growth condition. I don't think so. But yeah, it's uniform. Yeah.
Okay.
So I would like now to go more in some more detail of the proof. So I give a sketch of the proof of 1, that this operates here and brings a process again here. So I have to show that all terms of the can I use this blackboard? Okay. So sorry, but I just write the stochastic differential equation once more. And I won't erase it because it's on that blackboard. I need it also later. So sorry for that. So, well, the strong solution of my stochastic differential equation was a process which satisfies this. Okay, it's better to have all this term written here, right? To explain. And to show that S is bringing a process X, yeah? So S was just the right-hand side. So S of zeta t was simply what is on the right hand side, yeah? And to show that it is bringing a process in the space S2 to the space S2, finally I have to control all these terms here, the drift term and the noise term, and show that if zeta is in S2, then this term is in S2, and the same here. That's all, yeah? Okay, so as I mentioned before, here I use the properties of the inequality we have. If you are in a Hilbert space, you use isometry. Or if you are in R also, obviously, then you wouldn't have sometimes, instead of inequality, just an equal. But okay, so let me show first of all, how to control the drift term. So the drift term is controlled because, so now I want to show that the norm in S2 of the drift term is fine. Okay, so this is less equal to, oh, in the drift term is easy to handle. I just, this was t, obviously. But then the soup is simply obtained by taking the integral anti big T. So this is a s zeta s square in the s. And this is less equal to, due to the growth condition that I posed, this is smaller equal to m, constant in the growth condition, times the integral 0 t of the norm of zeta s squared plus 1 in the s. Okay, this simply applied the growth condition, and this is again equal to m times t plus the expectation of the integral of 0 t norm of zeta s square in the s. And this again is then equal to m times t of 1 plus the expectation of, the norm, in fact, of our process Zt. So the expectation of the soup, t in 0 t, of the norm of zeta s square. And this is obviously now finite because our hypothesis was that zeta t is in our st2, yeah? Okay, this is obviously the easy part. Now, how to handle the noise part. Okay, to handle the noise part, we need to use the Dub inequality, which I will prove in the tutorial, and which is always true for any martingale. So, to handle the second part, we use the noise because Bart, we use loops inequality for p equal 2. Loops inequality for p equals 2 says the following. It says that given any martingale, so the expectation of the soup, so the norm in fact in S2, it's our norm in S2, what I have here on the left hand side of mt square, is less equal to 4 of the expectation of the martingale at the time big T. So our norm in S2 is controlled by the second moment of the martingale in the last time T. Okay, so we assume the inequality to have been proven. It was proven, but we will do it in the tutorial. And okay, now we can go on controlling the noise coefficient and showing that if zeta is in S2, then the noise coefficient is also in S2. That is that the norm of the noise term, which is the expectation of the soup of t in 0 t, of the norm of integral to 0 t of sigma s zeta s in d ls is less equal to 4. Now I just use loop inequality to the second moment of the noise term. But now we see immediately, okay, now we have done due to the inequality we have. Because we know that this second moment, this is the norm in the space of squared integrable martingales. We know that due to the M type 2 condition, this is bounded. So this is less equal to 4k. K was this constant due to the structure of the M type 2 spaces. Is bounded by the second move of the coefficient sigma in the L2 norm. Okay, now if you don't like my M type 2 spaces, you can assume that sigma is Hilbert valued, then you wouldn't get here an inequality. You would have an isometry. So this would simply be equal to 4d, which is the variance of the Levy process, times this. So if you don't like my M type 2 spaces, think of Hilbert space and do an equality here, because then it would be simply an isometry. Okay. So now I didn't do all the details which are really equal as for the drift term, because now we have the same point, right? Just substitute instead of a sigma, and you obtain exactly the same. So due to the same calculation as before, in the case we consider with Poisson random measure, it's more complicated. You have to do something more. But in this case, you have done, because then due to the same calculation as before, you end up with the same. So this is smaller equal to mt of 1 plus the expectation of the sup of the norm zeta s squared. And you have done, because this is now the norm in the S2 space. Okay? Okay, so this proof, okay, I didn't prove this, but this in principle is done by the same trick. I use the same medicine, let's say. So now let's say that the proof is done. So now the conditions I posed can be relaxed, like you also know from analysis. For example, you can take local Lipschitz condition. So let me just mention how you solve the problem in the case your conditions are only local Lipschitz and not any more Lipschitz. So you reduce the problem to the Lipschitz condition. That is the trick. And you solve several uniqueness problems with Lipschitz condition in some sense. Now, theorem assume all conditions before. I just write it like this. I don't write the conditions again. All conditions like before, like theorem one, let's say, but beside the Lipschitz condition. That the Lipschitz condition is substituted by a local Lipschitz condition. Which is the following. The local Lipschitz condition tells us that for all n, there exists now a constant which depends on n such that the Lipschitz condition holds only locally for, let's say, a box which is less than n. That the integral of 0t of the norm of an of s zeta minus an of s epsilon squared in the s, then plus the same for the noise coefficient, is this time less equal to ln times zeta minus epsilon square. But this holds, yeah, for any t. But this holds now for zeta being in a box of sides n. So norm of zeta is less than n, and norm of epsilon is also less than n. So p almost surely. Okay, then if we assume this, we have again that there exists a unique, strong solution. In our space ST2. Of our stochastic differential equation. Okay, here I really give only some sketch of the proof. So we do some trick. We reduce our case to the Lipschitz condition. We consider first coefficients which are Lipschitz which satisfy the Lipschitz condition and are defined in this way. They are equal to A, S, and now here, instead of putting zeta, I divide by 1 plus the distance of zeta from, yeah, if you like, a ball of size n or a box of size n. And the same for the noise coefficient. Okay, then An and sigma n satisfy the Lipschitz condition. So this means in particular that for all n, if I consider the stochastic differential equation n, let's say, with the coefficient a n and sigma n, so I consider d x t equal x0 plus sigma n s zeta t. Let me call it differently if you prefer. Okay. No. Dt. Oh, I'm sorry. This is A. Plus sigma t xt n in dlt. So each of this stochastic differential equation, there exists a unique solution xtn in the space st2, which is solution of it. Solution of this stochastic differential equation with the coefficient an and sigma n. Okay. Now, we want to get the solution of our final equation, here written in its integral form, in the limit n which goes to infinity. How to show that if I take the limit n to goes to infinity, I finally get a unique solution of the previous stochastic differential equation.
is een dx equal to this one x not on the right hand side?
Dx. Ah, sorry. Yeah, this should be not be there. Thank you. And then it should be written like that, right? Yeah. Thank you.
Okay.
So we define tau n to be the infimum of the time t such that the norm of zeta t n is bigger than equal n in the Banach space, the norm in the Banach space. So by the uniqueness of the solution of each of these stochastic differential equations depending on n, we have that the solution xtn coincides, is equal p almost surely to the solution n plus 1 for each t in this interval 0 tau n. So now the trick is to show that the probability, obviously this tau n depends on omega. In fact, it is a stopping time, and what is a stopping time, I will say this in the tutorial. But in any case, it's measurable, right? And adapted to the filtration. And now show that the union is of tau n, so that tau n is equal t, is equal 1. This means there will be some n where finally this tau n is equal t. But as this is true, this means in particular that the solution coincides. I mean, sorry. Once you have shown that there is this sum tau n, which finally is equal to the whole time t, which is the claim of this statement, you can show that from it it follows that x equal the limit when n goes to infinity of xn solves uniquely your previous equation. And the solution is in ST, because all the solutions were in ST2. Yeah, because as these two solutions are equal on each of this interval, if there is one time, if the the probability that the big time t is equal to some of these times here, then all these solutions must be equal. Okay.
How do you show that it is right continuous?
What?
It is a catalog function, right? It must be in your space ST.
Yeah, okay. I have to remember of the proof. Yeah, I want that it is the space of catalog functions. Correct. Let me think how we do this.
Yeah.
Okay, I have to do it first for Lipschitz, obviously.
Ah,
because isn't it clear? Because I mean, the operator S is again shifting everything in something which is Cadillac. I mean, the operator S was this right hand side here. So this is Cadillac.
Yeah, that is what is obvious.
Okay, maybe it is not obvious, but yes, we prove it. Yeah, I didn't see it yesterday because we proved it in the chapter before that this process you get here. Okay, no, wait, you don't need too much. Yeah, you don't need too much because I can tell you, I think we proved it before, but I think I know the answer immediately because, you know, we proved that this
use predictability of sigma?
No. No, I will tell now why. this here are the martingales which are square integrable and are adapted. Yeah? And what we prove, and this is some result we got recently, but I think that in some extent it existed already previously. What we prove, and this answers also your question, is that if you take, no, maybe I need this blackboard, but I don't find my here. What we prove is that, if I really want to be precise, let me take the notes. So this is maybe something which would be nice to present, but because I think it's important, the question. Therefore, we wrote this paper. It's Stefan Tappe. So this is to a paper with Stefan Tappe, but some of this result, maybe we did it in more generality, were probably existing by Metivier or Shirayev. No, I think rather Metivier. So if you now take, I denoted it before, the L2 spaces, yeah? L20T of measure, for example, in our case, it's R plus times, what do we have here? E times omega, right? And the measure we consider here is the Borel sigma algebra times the Borel in E and FT. So I look at all function which are measurable here with values in A Banach space, yeah? And, well, with respect to the measure, ds, the Lebesgue measure, times, times some measure here, which is sigma finite, times p. Okay, if you look at this, and now you look at, now it's a little bit more, okay. You make an intersection with all progressive measurable processes. This space here is isomorphic to the space that you would get by taking, instead of this sigma algebra here, the sigma algebra of predictable processes. So the sigma algebra generated by all left continuous stochastic processes. You can show that these are isomorphic. In particular, what does it mean? You have even more, not all, sorry, PT, predictable, the sigma algebra with the predictable. Not only this, you have even that this is isomorphic to the case where you take all the same thing with, like here, but intersecting with adapted processes, adapted for each x, fixed, yeah? So if I take this, And now I say simply I have adapted processes. I get also the same isomorphism. And what does it mean? It means in particular that this is a representant, can even be predictable. Yeah? So first, from our proof which I presented, you are right, I didn't prove Carlack property. I didn't think about that yesterday, because for me now, due to this result, everything is equal. But due to this isomorphism, you have for sure that you have a representant which is predictable. Okay. So this is not only true for that case, it's even more general. It is even true if instead of having here a Lebesgue measure, you would have a measure, new DS, which is absolutely continuous with respect to Lebesgue. You might even have this, and this isomorphism is still true. And okay, this is a result together with Stefan Tappe, which appeared this year, in fact. 2012, stochastic analysis and applications. And obviously we use it in the book, because then, before we had a longer proof in this. This is based on some paper with Atma Mandrika, and we had a much longer proof because of this reason. Yeah, you are right, I forgot to make this statement, thank you. Yeah. But now, due to this result, we don't need any more this length of the proof.
Yeah.
But before, we had to prove it, and we did it in a different way. And this was done in a paper, I don't remember the year, in stochastics, or stochastics reports, I think, or stochastics, in 2000. I don't know. I can check. I have them with me. Yeah, yeah. But the longer proof. But now we shorten it up. Okay. Okay. I can give an intuition to that. This is intuitive, finally. Yeah. Because you see, you suppose you have a process which is left continuous here, yeah? I mean, the Itô integral, when you define, for example, the Itô integral, you make a limit in L2. But in a limit in L2, you completely lose the properties of your, whether it's here continuous or here. I mean, in some sense, it's like you take your finger and you do like this. Because it's a limit in L2. So this is the intuitive answer why this process with L2 spaces are all isomorphic. And then if I now think about the proof, I have to think because the paper needed a lot to be accepted. No, no, that's not true. But anyway, I forgot it. How did we do it? We started with step function, and then again by density, but there was some trick which was taking an operator which shifts the time and showing that this operator was somehow acting in the same space or something like that. I have to check, sorry. I have also the article here, I think. Yeah. Okay, thank you. Oh, I'm too early. I can, if you like, if you prefer, I could also start the topic of the next lecture, if you like. So, okay. Yes, let me start. So, next time I have not to introduce too many definitions. So tomorrow I would like now to do something very similar, existence and uniqueness of stochastic differential equation, but that this time I will consider stochastic partial differential equation. So the stochastic partial differential equation, we will have an additional term which is given by an operator. And the difficulty is that the operator might be unbounded. So from analysis, you know all the problems you have with that, yeah, in solving that. And the problems we have in probability are similar. And now the tricks we use are exactly the same tricks. We have some problem more, but the problem we have more, I described them already today. And we solve it in the same way. So in some sense, if you know already SPDE from analysis and you have listened this talk, it's nothing new. But anyway, I will present it. So let me write the topic of tomorrow. I think observing this was nice because very often when you do a contraction like I did now, yeah? So many people who thought that when integrating with respect to Lévy or integrating with respect to Poisson random measure, they need at any point to show that there is a predictable version. So this takes so much, but it's not needed. And this is also not needed for the compensated Poisson random measure, because the compensated Poisson random measure is a product measure of this kind. So this result holds, yeah? Or you can even do it for additive processes in case the additive processes are like this, have a compensated measure like this, which is, again, absolutely continuous with respect to DS. Then also, in that case, you don't need predictable condition. OK. So this predictable condition was, in fact, introduced by people who were analyzing much more general additive processes and point processes, which didn't have these nice properties here, but were more complicated, in fact. And then, as, for example, Ikeda Watanabe, as this book is very beautiful, everybody then does what is in this book. And yeah. OK. So tomorrow I would like to consider stochastic partial differential equation. This time I do it with state space in a Hilbert space, because we were able to solve it only on that case, because we need one additional trick, which is due to, we need one additional result due to Ichikawa. So in this case, I will consider only separable Hilbert space. So the stochastic partial differential equation is exactly what we had before, which is there was some progressively measurable drift coefficient depending on the solution, plus progressively measurable noise coefficient depending also on the solution and on omega both. And here I'm integrating in DLT. In fact, we did it with respect to Poisson random measure. But here there is an operator acting. So let me speak about this operator. So A and sigma are, as usual, progressively measurable. So the operator A is the infinitesimal operator of a pseudo-contraction semigroup, and I will introduce it. ST. On H. So ST is a semigroup on H if it has the following properties. So ST is an operator from H to H and is bounded for each T. And moreover, the following properties hold. At time zero, it is the equal to the identity operator. It has the semigroup property. It is continuous, but not in the norm sense, but point by point, at time t equals zero. And then I told here it is a pseudo contraction semigroup because we have some bound, exponential bound on the operator. And this is what we needed in our calculation. So S0 is equal to the identity. It is a semigroup, so at time t plus s, it is acting like first applying s, the operator at time s, and then applying the operator at s time t for t and s bigger equal to zero. Yeah? And it is continuous, but not in the norm. So not in the supnorm of the operator. It's not continuous in the operator norm. It's only continuous for each x fixed in H. And it is a pseudo-contraction semigroup because the norm of ST is bounded by e to some constant alpha t for alpha bigger than zero fixed. This is the pseudo contraction property. So A is the infinitesimal generator of some pseudo contraction semigroup. So A is an operator which is in a subdomain of H, which is, however, dense in H. And is for each x which is in the domain, and the domain is there where this, what I write here, makes sense. For each x where it makes sense, ax is the limit of st of x minus x divided by t. So the domain of A are all x for which this limit exists and is finite. So dA is the collection of all x such that the limit of t going to 0 of st x minus x divided by t exists. Okay, dA is a dense subset of H. Okay, so this is what we will do tomorrow. And we will see that, again, if A and sigma are Lipschitz, then we have a unique solution of a unique Mild solution. We use what the Mild solution is. Sorry, I didn't understand the. Yeah. I don't know whether I apply Yoshida theorem. What I do is simply, why to do a mild solution? Because very often you don't have a strong solution. So I will discuss this at the beginning. Yeah, that very often you don't eventually have a strong solution, and therefore you introduce a mild solution. Or very often you might have it, but you don't know whether you have it or not. Yeah, especially if you apply this in finance, we have one. For example, the forward interest rate are described by a stochastic differential equation of this kind, the Heath-Jarrow-Morton. Then in finance, you never know whether you have a strong solution because you even don't know, are not able to calibrate from the beginning. You want to find the correct model. So a priori, you don't know. So you look for the mild solution because eventually the strong solution might not exist. But I will discuss this. I will discuss it even first without the Levy noise very shortly. Okay. Thank you.
Yeah.